Okay, we should be live soon. We might be live right now. I don't know. But this isn't a horror game. Okay, yeah, we're live. But this isn't a horror game, for one.
Despite how the title's screen looks, huh?
It's an adventure game. Apparently it's a short adventure game where we play an agent of death. And we have to decide... we're playing an agent of death. You know what? Here, I'll just let the... help explain it, okay? Postmortem is a short exploratory adventure game taking place in official fictional industrial age country of Galicia, ravaged by 5 years of violent rioting between two ideologically and economically divided communities. You play as Death Incarnate, sent to a fundraising gala with the objective of claiming a single life from any of its attendants and staff. By exploring the space, conversing with the patrons, and uncovering various clues, you will learn about the world and the characters, revealing how their deaths might or might not influence the country. But how much should you meddle with mortal affairs? Perhaps a random choice is the fairest. What other effects could your involvement have? Also, I need to do this. There we go. Okay. So there, okay? And like I said, it's been so long in the title screen that it was playing Pop Goes the Weasel, like an orchestral version of Pop Goes the Weasel, which I found really weird. But anyway, let's start.
Maybe it's not licensed.
All right, well, let's see. It says, please proceed to your briefing. Oh, God. Okay. Welcome to Postmortem. This room functions as a brief tutorial. Follow these guides to learn how to play the game, or step through the doors to skip the tutorial. You can rebind controls by running the keybinder.exe program in the game's folder. This tutorial will refer to the default values, however. Use WASD or the arrow keys to move, which I've already demonstrated. Good. You can use E to interact with the world, like doors or furniture. A magnifying glass icon shows objects that can be interacted with. Walk up to the table on the left and press E to read the newspaper on it. Log. Case profile number 2442-G-2. Country, Galicia. Date, October 18th, 1897. Population, 1.9 million. Expected R, plus 3 per month. A country in its early stages of industrialization, torn by almost 5 years of violent domestic conflict called the Turmoil. Operative, assigned, pending review, status incomplete. Okay, that's us. We're the people. We're the agent. You can also use E to talk with others. A speech bubble will appear above them. During conversation, use number keys and or your number pad to make dialogue choices. I don't even need the mouse. Fuck you, mouse. Now, walk up to the character and speak with him. Okay, well, let's E. I'll press 1. Welcome, agent. The powers that be demand you take one life tonight. The choice is yours. The choice is mine, you say. We're sending you to I did not press 3. Or 2. I pressed 3. We're sending you to Galicia tonight. How much do you know about the place? I don't know at all. Anything at all. Well, no matter. You're not here to meddle with mortal affairs. Get in, pick a life, get out. Do be careful, however. The place is pretty unstable right now, with a violent civil conflict between the newager and older... Are you shitting me?
Old ager grouped.
I'm not saying that. I'm not finishing that. I'm not, no. I am ready. Good. The turmoil is why we are sending you to a fairly peaceful and safe gala. You know the type. High profile fundraising event for some vandalized high school. Shouldn't be too much trouble. What? Why was the school vandalized? I do not know much, but I believe Rose Hill High is one of the few schools which refused to segregate students based on their beliefs and social status. Angry parents, on both sides, protested that policy rather directly. Alright, so there's lots of big influential characters. Among others, it's an open event, so you might see people from all paths of life. Alright. In any case, don't get too involved. Just be prompt and efficient. We don't do overtime, you know. Well, fuck you. I want my overtime pay. You know what? Fine.
I'm understood.
Good. This isn't some sort of a game. You don't win a prize at the end. Just claim us a life tonight. Whatever works for you. Oh, and one more thing. Not that it matters, but what gender would you like to appear to mortals? You know what? Male. Poof. All done. I was already male, so fuck you. Magic. Now go up ahead, then.
Do you remember what gender you were before you were?
My gender was attack helicopter.
Uh-huh.
Uh-oh. But
you
but
still
the,
need to talk to her?
I don't think so. Alright. Okay, yeah, but how do I go through the doors? Okay, so our notebook is Q or N. And... okay, space. Open the door with E and go through to begin. Okay.
Seems easy enough.
Okay, we're gonna be at our first party, I guess. October 18th, 1897. Galicia. City of Antrim. Come on, how much more... Okay, that's it? We're done being specific? Okay. Okay, you just want to kill someone at random first?
Sure.
Okay, okay,
first
well...
First guy we meet.
First guy we meet? Okay. Time to die, bitch! Gary O'Neill? Yeah, fuck you, Gary! You were chosen! Okay. You've made your decision. Press space to continue through these messages. The Antrim Daily. All the news that's fit to print. 6 a.m. special, your morning source of news. Unexpected death shocks charity gala. A fundraising gala for the benefit of the recently vandalized Rose Hill High School took a grim turn when close to midnight, Gary O'Neill suddenly collapsed. The cause of death is still unknown, explained Dr. Vimes, but initial analysis suggests heart failure. Gary, I'm gonna say, is that Jerry? It's a really weird spelling of Jerry, so fuck it, it's gonna be called Gary. Gary was a young student of Rose Hill High, volunteering at the gala as a waiter. The gala's host and CEO of Sheldon Glassware Incorporated expressed his sincere condolences but hopes the tragic event will not damage his image or company. Oh shit. In an act of goodwill, he promoted an experienced server, Franz Cole, to head of human resources. Rose Hill High was only able to raise part of the necessary funds needed for its renovation, remaining just one of many organizations affected by the city's turmoil, or the country's turmoil. Okay. Wow. Okay, there's a lot of these news. Okay.
I don't think you have to read all of them. Just.
I mean,
you know.
I will. I'll read ones that are unique. TFF violence on the rise. Trenter Freedom Force, the most radical and violent pro-old-ager terrorist group in the country, has admitted to some structural problems in recent months, particularly after the passing of one of its key. What? He was a terrorist?
Dude,
he was a terrorist, one of its key members.
Oh my god,
he was a key member. Okay, one of its key young members, Gary O'Neill, former student of Rose Hill High. Gary's rather fanatical involvement with the organization was uncovered shortly after a charity gala for the benefit of his school, hosted by the successful businessman Bill Selden. With the passing of the promising young leader, TFF lacks a central... Was he the leader? We killed the leader!
Key young members. I don't think it was necessarily leader.
It says the passing of the promising young leader, TFF lacks a central unifying voice. We picked a random citizen and killed the leader. We killed a terrorist leader at random. And also sirens. That's what happens when you kill people at random.
Actually, it kind of fits in this game.
No. Anyway, TFF lacks a central unifying voice, growing even more chaotic and disorganized. Splinter cells were known to occasionally act without official approval, resulting in more senseless violence. The group, seeing no change in political and economic sphere among the wealthy businessmen such as the aforementioned Mr. Selden, and struggling to fill the void left by Gary, has been slowly intensifying their violent activity, continuing its fight for the old ager cause. Holy shit! Okay. Gloomy day for Galicia Connolly's 5-point plan refuted. Oh, gloomy day for Galicia Connolly's 5-point plan refuted. As many of our readers will remember, Prime Minister Connolly's new 5-point plan, a simple but highly anticipated plan for finally bringing the Galician turmoil to an end, was unveiled a week ago. After a week of strenuous negotiations, the plan was finally refuted this morning by both sides of the conflict, including the TFF, which stayed fairly ambivalent about it. Where were the prominent speakers and influential business lobbyists of our nation during the crucial week, our readers might ask? Country's beloved Ophelia Thatcher, which might actually have been a name in history, had little
kind of
impact.
The Iron Lady.
Iron Lady? I don't know.
That was Margaret Thatcher, though.
Yeah, okay. Had little impact on the negotiations, but now we can see that she played her card smart by holding off on her radical pro-women and gay rights agenda. Ah, good old 1897. At one of the charity galas I attended, someone reminded me that with all the fighting, speaking out now would only further destabilize the political scene and make me a new target for hate, explained Ophelia. With the two sides still hostile towards each other, trying to push these social policies would undoubtedly further divide the political sphere. Our young Ophelia is indeed shaping to be quite a shrewded politician. Shrewd. That's a word?
Shrewd.
Yeah, I thought that was without the E. Politician herself, much to her parents' pride. Wealthy lobbyists did little to help the negotiations, always at odds with the old agers' pleas. Some analysts argue that if just a few of the more successful and promising CEOs could have been convinced to change their policies, their involvement would have panned out differently. But perhaps now is not the time for grave economic shifts, potentially further destabilizing the country. Maybe that is why so many HR managers, such as Franz Kohl, recently hired by Selden's Glassware, still oppose radical reforms, including hiring female workers. So while we may not be seeing neither New Ager businesses upping their production and increasing profits, nor better wages and policies benefiting the Old Ager workers, at least Galicia remains economically stable in the otherwise very turbulent times. This refutation of the Connolly plan proves yet another obstacle on Galicia's already rocky path. Furthermore, the vandalism of the mixed Rose Hill High School a few months back and failure to raise the necessary funds to renovate reminded us of our lacking institutions to promote long-term reconciliation and showed that, even if the politicians may be nodding their heads, the regular folk are not yet ready to shake the other side's hand. Due to your involvement, the Galician turmoil continued for 2 more years before a case fire. Case fire? Is this game in English? A case fire agreement was brokered. The level of violence and random attacks did not decrease during that time, however. With conservative leaders and lacking facilities, like Rose Hill High, Galicia's future was uncertain as it embarked on the long and difficult process of reconciliation. The denizens of Hangfors continued being terrorized by random acts of animal violence?
Animal violence?
Oh, hi, Jerry! Well, you're kinda dead.
You will find out soon
enough. Why? Well, you know what? Somebody had to die tonight. Why did you choose me?
I chose randomly.
What? That's not fair. Actually, that's the fairest choice of all. I was unbiased. Well, are you happy yourself choosing me to die? You know what? I don't care. I don't know. So what will happen to me now?
No, don't care. Not my department.
That's not my department, Jerry. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to defer you to accounting. Don't ask me why, okay? I know accounting doesn't do that thing, but I'm just deferring you to accounting anyway. Yeah, fuck you, Jerry. So I guess I step into the light or something? Actually, step into the darkness! How grim. I guess it's a goodbye then. Yeah, you know what? Bye, Jerry. Thank you, I guess. You know what, Jerry? You're welcome. Yes, bye, Jerry! For someone who had to die, Jerry did not want to die. Oh, hey, look! Case number 42442G2. Status closed. Result pending review. Okay, I guess we return to the main menu. Oh, shh. He's ringing around the rosy. Okay. I just wanted to get to the, you know, the bop, 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 bop. Anyway, let's go through the doors.
We all fall down. Wait, we're still playing the tutorial? That kind of stupid.
Well, yeah, but, I mean, I can just do this.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so, do you want to go at random again and kill the woman this time? Or do you want to actually, like, investigate?
Let's try to do the investigation type thing.
Okay.
Or we can try killing Mr. Selden.
That was actually going to be my next suggestion. let's go talk to Mr. Selden. Let's try to find him.
Unless the story changes with each load.
I don't think so. I think the story's the same. I think it's just, like, Yeah, there's Jerry. Okay, who are you? Oh, it's Franz Kohl! Remember him?
Mm.
He was, like, a businessman or something. We just read it out loud, and I already forgot what the fuck happened. Good evening! Should I bring you a glass? You know what? Yeah, bring me a glass. We have some fine oak casket. Aged with... Yeah! You know what? No, I'm not gonna do it. And scotch, as well as the finest sparkling wine one will find at this end of Galicia. You know what? I'll have some whiskey. Well, here you go, saw. You know what? I will. Thank you. I must be going now. Okay, so we know that that's Franz Kohl. Okay, who are you? I don't know who the fuck you are. You're John Dowers. I don't know. You know what? I gotta be... You know what? Tell me about somebody, okay? Tell me about Franz. Quite a talkative waiter, which I suppose is a good thing. A good chat is a sure way to get to great tips. No surprise Mr. Selden takes so kindly to him. I think he even mentioned a potential big promotion. Well, what did you guys talk about? Oh, this and that. Dishes, his work, I think he has a lot of frustration pent up. Pent up frustration, you say?
He gave you whiskey, you can't kill him now.
Ekaterina, okay. You know what? I'm just gonna be going.
Is that a typo?
I don't know. But she's in my fucking way. Oh! Oh, we have to find a key. Okay, what do you think a key would be?
Maybe it's in that nightstand? Or with somebody else?
Aha! It's in a bedroom! Oh, Jesus. I don't want to read all that. Maybe it's in here? No. You know what?
It's like...
What?
Well, we are a ghost or the Reaper, so I guess we could do that.
We're just gonna hide here and watch things unfold. You know, let's talk to Jerry.
You're basically playing Hitman with this kind of game.
Hello. Hello there, old chap. My name is Jerry. I'm a student at Rose Hill High, volunteering at the event tonight. Oh, well, what are you doing? Ah, just small stuff. Carry food. Get people's coats. Nothing major. Anyway, can I get out of this? Can I get out of this? Can I get out of this?
There's no escape button.
Can I get out of this? Oh god, I'm trapped.
Nope, you're gonna be stuck there for life.
Jerry, stop talking! Shut the fuck up, Jerry!
This is why we killed you!
Oh my god! I don't know, Jerry, okay? Holy shit, I'm not reading all this. Fuck off, Jerry!
Too. Oh, hey!
How do they fight? You seem high in their views. No, I don't think you're... Can I... Shut up, Jerry! There! You know what?
Wow. Don't kill him again.
Fuck you, Jerry!
Now, viewers, if you wanted to see any of that dialogue, please, you know, when it comes up on YouTube, pause the film.
No, fuck it, okay? Jerry's a stupid motherfucker. Blah! Just fuck you, Jerry!
So does the character actually change if you say you're female?
I'm not gonna bother that. Look, I'm tired of Jerry shit already, okay?
You've killed him twice already, so you... Hello?
Hmm?
Mm. Oh, okay.
That's my... I have a bunch of water in my mouth. Because okay. I need to, you know... drink water, because water is good for me. You know, I'm a growing boy. And... yeah.
Can we claim the secretary, or is that just not a thing they do?
What, kill the secretary?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, sure, maybe after we kill Jerry again.
Yeah, probably not, because it starts when we leave the doors.
Oh, that's true. Well, I mean, they do tell us how to kill people, though. We could True. Try killing our secretary. Although I don't think HR would approve.
Well, nobody said I wanted this job.
Okay, so let's... What the fuck is that?
That's Sheldon.
Okay, let's be real, though. Let's be nice this time. Rose Hill High devastated. Sheldon to hold fundraiser. Destroyed playgrounds, broken windows, and political graffiti is what greeted Rose Hill High School principal Ronald Gilchrist when he entered the school grounds on the morning of September 6th. Gilchrist's staunch non-segregation policies, allowing children of both New Agers and Old Agers to be educated in the same classroom, appear to be the reason for the attack, judging from the graffiti. They play at being focused on our future, but they're simply beasts. Said Principal Gilchrist. Destroying an educational facility is the antithesis of your progress, no matter how your politics lean. Bill Sheldon, CEO of Sheldon Glassware Incorporated, announced a plan to host a charity gala to raise funds for renovating the school. High-profile guests, including the Thatchers of Gal Media fame, have already expressed interest in attending and providing generous donations. Old Ager proponents have noted that, Mr. Sheldon has no children nor has ever married, and believe this to be a sympathy grab from the New Ager upper class.
No, it's because his glassware company is going to get more money by building windows for the school.
Okay, that was Franz, right? Yeah, that was Franz. Well, who's this? Is this... Oh, hey, it's Ophelia Thatcher. I don't care for your pleasantries. I need to get going. I'm sorry for ever talking to you.
Hey, at least she shut up right away.
Yeah. Not like Jerry! Existence is pain to a meeseeks Jerry, and your freaking dialogue extended that existence!
Oh, no, wait a minute. That newspaper's only 5 cents.
Hey, wait a minute. You're right.
The other one was 10. The price must go up after... Oh, that was 4 years ago.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that is an old newspaper. Good eye, by the way. Mm. What's this doing here?
I don't know. It's a waiting room.
Oh, okay. I mean, it is the waiting room for heaven. It hardly matters. Oh, military to quell Trenter riots. It hardly matters who the original aggressor was anymore, as, mere weeks later, riots in Trenter show little signs of slowing. Both old-ager and new-ager protesters' chants, claiming the city was their home, quickly escalated into violence on Tuesday. Local constabulary tried to no avail to calm the crowd, becoming itself engulfed in the uncontrollable riots. Shelters for local families have been constructed, allowing a place for those who have had their homes destroyed to seek refuge from the violence and help identify bodies of those slain. "This is not politics, it is pure hate," remarked one of the Trenter citizens, rushing to see his injured son at the overcrowded hospital.
Aww.
Prime Minister Darkins has finally approved an official request for military intervention in Trentner. But many fear this may only serve to escalate the violence further. Okay, well, let's see. What are you listening to on your lunch break? Tune in for your daily broadcast with the Thatchers. Your Galicia, your news. Not for those dirty immigrant... Oh, well, fuck, you know what? Well, I mean, she's right here, and she hates immigrants, so we could kill her.
She's the one that was trying to fight for women and gay rights, wasn't she?
I think... Oh, it's Franz. It's his jacket. Yeah, let's pick his
fucking... He won't have the room key, though.
Women, know your place. It's not in the... It's... Oh, well, okay.
Wow. It seems like everybody deserves to die.
Yeah, but who deserves to die the most is the question.
I go with... I keep wanting to call him Sheldon. Selden.
Selden? Okay. Well, let's see if we can find any dirt on Selden before we decide to kill him.
I have a... sneaky suspicion that because he's the glassware company, yeah, I'm so thinking that he's just there to have them do the windows.
I thought I could actually select this because it was blue.
I did too.
Oh, hey, the new 5-point plan. Okay. Oh, the
that
new
was still 5 cents, but that's recent.
Yeah. With tensions high as we approach the 5th year anniversary of the Galician turmoil, Prime Minister Connolly is planning to unveil a new 5-point plan to bring a ceasefire and embark on path to reconciliation. Will this new plan succeed? The pro-old-ager culture Unforgotten Coalition, now holding 35% of the popular vote, will need a lot of convincing after the insult they saw MacDillan's plan to be 2 years ago. Even less likely is the militant Trenter... They keep alternating. Fucking shit. Freedom Force agreeing to any ceasefire pending negotiations. Only a new open-minded leadership could sway the group's agenda at this point. Things are equally grim on the other side of the fence, with People of Progress, now close to 40% of the popular vote, still vehemently against compromising its strong pro-New-Ager platform. With political donations from powerful players, such as the Thatchers, those key figures will undoubtedly have to be swayed first. Regardless of the plan's outcome, the coming weeks will play a crucial role in Galicia's future. With so many influences, a single key speaker or a single swayed opinion could have far-reaching consequences. The turmoil is as likely to come to a peaceful end as to extend by many more years of violence, and this sentence seems like it was a metaphor for some reason. Even so, rebuilding and reconciliation will be a difficult process requiring much open-mindedness on parts of various institutions, a real challenge given the recent vandalism of the fully integrated Rose Hill High. But perhaps the school can dispel our fears and prove a model for the future. Okay, well, we still need to find... Oh, yeah, we already talked to him.
Yeah, we did.
Oh, it's a bookshelf. Oh, shit, what is this? Cold stale coffee bread. And stale bread.
Albert stood on the front steps of his shop, his morning cup warming his hands against the autumn chill. In the past, like his father before him, Albert had made it a habit to come greet every sunrise this way, welcoming each day with the same kindness and dedication he put into his work. He remembered standing there as a boy, a warm half-mug and piercing rays from the sun darting over the hills, gently illuminating every laugh line and weathered wrinkle on his father's smiling face. It was the face of an honorable man, Albert always thought. The face of the earth. His father would take a sip, and Albert would mimic, trying with all his youthful might to keep his face from scrunching like a bulldog at the bitter taste he had yet to develop an appreciation for. Most children don't really enjoy coffee, but he drank it for his father. It was their secret, a bond between father and son that mother was best left out of. Well, fuck you too. As the sun finally crested, casting warmth and glow over the little shop at the end of the lane, his father would instruct him to run and fetch the sign with the daily specials, even letting him write on it himself at times. He would then unshackle the old wood shutters and the big bay windows would spring forth, showing the little bakery his grandfather had built before him. Finally! You have some static coming from your end.
Do I? I thought I had it on mute.
That's probably why there was some static.
Oh.
Okay. Anyway. Finally, he would run to retrieve the fresh loaves, their warm smell drawing the passing workers starving for their breakfast bread and meat. Those days were gone, however. Now his coffee was often cold if he left any of it in the mug, waiting to see the sun over the towering behemoths of steel and glass that blocked the hills at the end of the lane. In truth, Albert never saw the sunrise anymore. My voice is cracking a lot. But merely a reflection from the glass. Often even that is obscured by the thick gray smoke that now clouds the horizon. Standing there in his flower-coated apron, all he could do was watch the long line of black automobiles that came to park in a line, open their doors as countless men in black suits and slick hair poured out, shaking each other's hands greedily. After them, as his coffee chilled further, he would come the workers. Together, as if by some external alien force, the click and clack of their steel-toed shoes would unite into a single march, filling the air with a booming beat. It was the marching of an army, Albert would think, remembering the old days of his adolescence. But what war are they going to fight? No, not an army. An honor guard. Representing the smut-covered and wrinkly colors of industrialism. They no longer had time for their morning bread, and even the wage was better saved. For a man's wage was his life, and this wasn't much life to be had. Once gone, the morning, still early by the sun's reckoning, would shudder from the grinding gears and screaming machinery. Like from a dragon's cave, smoke and roars came from the slender steel stacks blocking his view as the bread slowly grew stale.
Mm-hmm.
That's depressing. Oh, hey. Well, that's a depressing.
Isn't also, that the same photo?
It is the same photo. What's this? What's here?
Is that the time, or what?
I have no idea. Okay. Well, who are you people? Oh, hey! My name is Death!
Welcome. I do not believe we have met. Who might you find, sir, be?
My name is Death. Pleasure to meet...
Death.
No, that's Death.
Death!
Pleasure to meet you, Death. I do not seem to recall your name on the guest list. Not that this poses a problem, of course. Our gala is open to the community, but pray tell, what walk of life might you be coming from?
Let's be honest with them. One.
Why have you not heard of the Death and Death Incorporated Enterprises? We are quite a growing force, sir. Oh dear, I do apologize for my ignorance. Clearly, I will need to speak with a few of my associates about telling me such vital information. In any case, I'm glad to have bright and promising individuals attending our event tonight. I hope your growing enterprise would be interested in providing a generous donation to this worthy fundraiser. You know what? Certainly we would. Most excellent. Good evening. How many? You know, fuck you, Bill. Okay, you want to kill Bill Selden?
Yep.
What the?
We can't kill him? Oh. We can pick where he can die?
Yeah, I guess so.
I don't want to kill him in the center of the room. That's where we killed everybody else. That's...
Oh, God.
Jerry did it!
Move out of the fucking way, Jerry! Can I push him into his room?
No, because we don't have the key for his room.
But we don't have the key for any room!
Oh. No, you get back over there.
Uh-oh. Like, we don't have the key for any room.
But it says you should be able to find a key somewhere.
Okay, yeah, let's check the fucking... Okay.
So far, the only one I found was in the coat of the one closet.
Yeah, okay, something's fishy here. Is there, like, a pickpocket? Whoa, okay.
That's interesting. Uh-huh. What about any of the coats over there?
Oh, yeah, that's... No. Doesn't seem to be. Who are you? Oh, is this Ekaterina? Fucking Jerry. Okay, maybe we have to wait for Bill Selden to do something. Says maybe there's a key somewhere, but where?
I thought we were in every room so far.
Maybe we have to talk to people? And try to get the key from them? Okay. So, what we could... You know what, let's try to get... Maybe if we talk to Selden... About something. Maybe, just maybe... He has a key. And...
Or we just follow him and maybe he's going back to his room?
Yeah, that's another thing I'm thinking of.
Or not.
No, he could be... He could be going to the other room. Maybe. Okay, do you want to try random dialogue presses?
Sure.
You know, let's talk about the conflict. I've spoken enough of that already, and I would rather not spoil the mood further. Tonight is supposed to be about a bright future, not a painful past.
Something else, then.
Yeah, very well, something else, then. Now tell me about yourself, Mr. Selden. My, where do I start?
At the beginning.
Why, yes, I was born here in Antrim in 1833. My father was a proud founder of the Selden Glassware Incorporated. A moderately successful business specializing in making glass dishes and ornaments. My mother has been quite a world traveler and part of many charity organizations, even despite being wheelchair bound. She passed away when I was still just a child. Death is a natural part of life. Well, yes, I suppose that is true. In any case, I came to terms with it long ago.
Okay.
After finishing school, my father employed me in a managerial position at his company.
When he passed away, I moved into the CEO position. I quickly recognized a few, shall we say, shortcomings of my father's limited policies. It's only expected that a new CEO, such as yourself, might, you know, should improve on the former's work. Indeed, and so I did. You see, when my father began his company through his love of making glassware, he failed to realize that the dish and cookery market was only so big. But I noticed that there was much more demand for glass manufacturing in a whole different industry. Windowing.
Ha!
So you capitalized on a new market? Precisely! I revamped many of our plants into window glass manufacturing, met with a lot of powerful supplies, and the rest is history. Nowadays, Selden Glassware provides all forms of products, but it was this initial change that really pushed us forward.
Did it call it?
You know what? Fascinating. Indeed, albeit I was just the right man at the right place, following that simple current of business. After all, isn't this whole point of business to make money? You know what? Good for you. As long as the profits keep increasing, you have done your duty to your shareholders. Yes, yes! I'm glad you agree. As they say, great minds think alike. You know what? I suppose we both just understand the value of good business. Exactly, exactly. I must admit, I quite like you. You seem to have a progressive mind. We need more people like you in Galicia. Pray tell, are you familiar with the Ottoman fire incident a few years back? We read the paper.
Yep.
Yes. It was a sad incident that showed just how irrational many so-called old ages can be, wouldn't you agree? Perhaps the... Yes, the factory would create efficient mode of transportation and provide people with jobs. Quite so. It was a formidable step back. And for what? The automobiles can revolutionize the entire industry. Not only personal transport, but any industry would benefit from faster and more efficient transfer of goods if we could just rearrange some of the roads to suit the routes better. A city needs to be flexible, it needs to grow, it needs to change, it needs to adapt. Just what we say here at Death and Death Incorporated Enterprises. Exactly! As new tools and ideas emerge, our lifestyle will adjust to them. In the end, these changes will make everyone's lives easier. So many people in Galicia seem to be stuck in the mindset that making improvements to our culture is somehow destroying it. You know what? Culture needs to also change and improve. The more I talk with you, the more I see you understand the need for progress. It's reassuring to see someone agreeing with my beliefs.
Here's my key. Oh.
In any case, this has been great food for thought for me. I will braggingly admit I was recently honored to be invited by the New Ager People of Peace Party to give a public speech for the new 5-point plan on their behalf.
Spare me the details.
Congratulations. Why, thank you. I'm just happy some recognize the importance of business in Galicia's future. But I know about it. Oh, very well. I've kept you long enough. Do go mingle for a bit and consider donating for Rose Hill High. It is so important we have strong facilities to serve as a model for reconciliation. Well, we didn't get a key at all.
Hmm.
Okay. I feel we discussed my past and viewpoints enough for now, unless you're here to inquire about my love life like so many have been lately. Well, sir, why are people inquiring about your love life? I wish I knew. I have led a life of a bachelor for quite some time now. Well, there's nothing wrong with being single, sir. That's exactly how I feel, and I've long outgrown the lifestyle of a ladies' man. So how come you're single now?
Sadly, a successful businessman means a lot of work, and I frankly just did not have the time to dedicate to relationships. But I've gotten quite used to it, and truly, how can one ever be so lonely with so many lovely people around? You know what? Money can certainly fill the void in one's life. Now, I never said that. Money can't buy you happiness. Though it certainly can buy you things that make you happy. Means to an end, as they say. Indeed. Now, anything else I can help you with? You know, let's talk about something else. Let's tell me about, yourself again. Oh, okay. Tell me about somebody. Tell me about, Ophelia. A fine thatcher. She will get far, farling her parents. I can already tell. Why would you think so? Okay, you know what?
And now we've gotten into the... We're gonna shut you up now. Now, here's an idea. They're all against, like, women and stuff. So if you play as a woman, you think they're gonna be more hateful to you?
Maybe we can convince Jerry.
You have made your decision.
Unexpected death. Oh, yeah, this time. Blah turns went suddenly collapsed. The cause of death is still unknown. The server at the event, Franz Cole, called the death God's punishment for using the vandalism of a small school as an excuse for a rich gala. Mr. Selden's death inspired some additional donations, helping Rose Hill High meet its funding needs. We will definitely be able to renovate the damaged buildings, but still have to face parental dissent, explained the principal, excited but somewhat uncertain of the school's future. Oh yeah, there we go. Yeah, there we go. Jerry, blah blah blah. Of course it's refuted. The Galician turmoil continued for 3 years! Jesus Christ! That wasn't good! Okay, so obviously he's not the guy to kill. The level of violence and random attacks did not decrease. Thanks to influential figures and strong new facilities like Rose Hill High, Galicia was able to embark on a promising... Well, we did stabilize, you know, Galicia.
Where is this animal that we can...
I have no idea. Okay, I'm thinking we just kill... Okay,
because it keeps saying about animal violence, but I don't... I think we need to read that article about the animal violence now.
What article?
There was one right beside his door about animal something or other that we kind of, like, clicked through.
Okay.
Don't want to read it all the way.
Sorry, Mr. Selden, you're dead. The powers that be demand I claim someone tonight. Why did I choose you?
I simply did not like you.
Oh, shit. I pressed the one on accident.
Aw.
Based on the you know what? I just had a hunch. Do not question my judgment, you fuck!
I'm glad I killed you.
You know what? I think I did a pretty good job. You're gonna go to hell, Mr. Selden.
Oh, I hope you're
I like number two. Everything you ever wanted in life, but the opposite.
Oh.
You know, step into the darkness, just go. Yeah, bye, Mr. Selden. I hear him laughing.
He hasn't said anything more in chat.
He's listening. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do.
Oh, okay.
Time for you.
Yay.
Okay, time for you to make the decisions. Which you've already been making the decisions, but now it's time for you to,
I didn't realize that it was a whenever I stepped in thing.
I mean, now it's going to be you. You're going to read our the dialogue of the killer, us, and then I'm going to read the dialogue of the guests.
Okay.
Which will make things, I think, far more enjoyable. Also, I don't know if you can see it, but, like, where I'm standing, you can see, like, the texture meshes. Which seems kind of sloppy. Anyway, okay, so next to the bedroom, you said?
Yeah.
This and this dresser?
Yeah, that one there.
Another heinous act of animal cruelty shocks denizens of Hangforce. The warm morning sun was not enough to protect Mercedes Aguilar from freezing in horror as she turned the corner of Axley Avenue while taking her young boy to school. The little side street was blocked by a dead peacock with a severed head.
Ew.
This was the third such occurrence in a recent bizarre wave of animal cruelty, mere weeks after the raccoon incident. The constabulary no longer believes them to be unfortunate accidents, but deliberate acts intended to terrorize the otherwise quaint town of Hangforce. It's those bloody New Ages, I tell ye! Miss Aguilar reported to us. The robber barons are trying to scare away our kids like at Rose Hill! However, Stanley Hornberger, kinky, the local representative of the pro-New Ager People of Peace Party, denounced such accusations. A beautiful peacock surely represents a New Ager, and the removed head is intended to send a negative message against us. Whoever the perpetrator is, these bizarre incidents are further dividing the local community, giving both New Agers and Old Agers yet another excuse to blame and detest the other and prolong our suffering.
Okay, let's talk to you, Katrina. Or however her name is pronounced.
Oh, hello, Gov!
About the gala.
Local school built being vandalized, rich people getting tough, or together and give money. We all feel better about ourselves for a few days. What's there to talk about?
Why did you come here, then?
I have my reasons, and as I suppose you do as well.
I'll tell you mine if you tell me yours.
Now you assume I actually care for your reasons. Unless you bring a stack of rare books, which I do not quite see you carrying. Enough chatter about this gala.
I'll be off then.
Rare books. What about these books? Oh wait, no, this is a candle.
You can't pick it up though or anything.
Can we... Oh shit, we have to okay, time to read all the, you know, all the shit again.
Does that unlock stuff by doing that?
I guess so.
Poster. Yeah.
Oh, whoops. That's it. This is locked.
But that door you could open and grab his thing. Is there anything else in his pockets, or was that the only thing?
That's it.
Okay.
What we could do is try to accuse him of being, you know, an asshole.
There's Cole right down there.
Oh, yeah, I know. I'm grabbing the articles from the upper parts.
Oh! Hey, there we go.
Okay, so we found the key. Oh, okay. What are we gonna find here? Well, hello, Hitler! Is your child's school breeding old agers? Would you let your child play with backward Philistines? Would you teach them traditionalist propaganda? Would you cripple their potential? Then why allow a school to do that? Boycott Rose Hill High. Do not let your child mix with old agers.
Wow.
Interesting. Oh, it's safe. I don't know what that is, but...
Somebody's child.
It is someone's child. Interesting.
Still no second key for the other room, though.
No...
Oh, let's talk to Selden again and ask about that photo, then. Welcome. That was his study, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you do it this time.
I am Death, and I have come here tonight to claim a life.
How, good show. You certainly have quite a sense of humor. I am honored to have Death itself visit our humble charity events.
I do hope you visit us for a charitable deposit and not a withdrawal.
I'll think about it.
Of course. Take your time and have a look at many of the wonderful items auctioned tonight. How can I help you?
Tell me about yourself.
My, where do I start? At the beginning, obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah.
That's a special part of life.
After finishing school. I mean, we complimented him with number two.
Yeah, let's continue that until we get to his love life.
Okay. Blah, blah, blah. Capitalized on a new market. Fascinating. You know, blah, blah, blah. Number one. Number one again. Let's keep... Yes, I'm a familiar. The factory would have created... easier. Culture needs to change and improve. Congratulations. I know about... You know what? Let's have him... Thank you, I will consider. Actually, I have more questions about you. Okay.
Was it still tell me about yourself for that?
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Okay, let's try. Are you married?
No, never have been. I've led a life of a bachelor for quite some time now.
That sounds sad.
Not at all. Being a polite and accomplished gent, I did have a few offers here and there. My bachelor status is of my own choosing.
Sounds like you have some juicy stories to tell.
Perhaps. But a true gentleman does not kiss and tell. Oh, no. Yeah, we've read this one.
But the unconditional love of someone, it's a thing of its own.
Perhaps, but I do not desire it any longer and do not lose sleep over it.
Spoken like a true shallow and empty capitalist.
Well, I never! Let us change the subject if it bothers you so deeply.
Yeah, I really must be going. I don't know.
Whoops. Oh. Hmm. Let's ask about Ekaterina.
I have no... I'll go with that pronunciation.
Okay, where's...
I think
where's...
it only asks about people that you've talked to before.
Franz? Franz, are you okay? Ah, here we go. Oh, he's voiced.
What?
Well, he was voiced. We have some fine no-cacks. Which one do you want?
Do you serve any food?
Of course you would choose that. Of course. Jerry is on food duty right now. He is the young lad somewhere around here. Catch him for some delicious snacks. I highly recommend the cheese crepes.
I'm lactose intolerant. Spelled wrong, by the way.
Tofu crepes.
I hate tofu.
Whoops, I love tofu. I recommend you use the extra firm one.
Uh-huh.
Press the water out of it into some nice towels, then fry it on the pan. It can get quite nice and crispy, while still moist and soft on the inside.
Sounds like a lot of effort. I could just eat a chicken wing.
Sadly, vegans and vegetarians of the world do not have such freedom.
It's a hard knock life.
Every day's a struggle.
In any case, something else I might want to ask you. I wanted to ask about the gala.
What would you like to know?
Have you donated or bought anything?
I am afraid not. I am here strictly as a worker and haven't had the time to really look at the goods.
We must be going.
Okay. That was kind of boring. Oh, books!
Sorry. Yeah. Wait a minute, look at that picture again. Okay. It's like the same book. I mean, it's kind of weird.
Yeah. Do you want to talk to this asshole?
We haven't yet.
John Dowers?
Tell me about yourself.
I am Dower, John Dower. Just a local watchmaker, not quite as skilled as my father, if you have heard of him. He passed away some years ago, unfortunately.
Have you considered other pursuits?
Well, I have been finding science and philosophy quite interesting as of late, and maybe because I work with watches so much, I've been reading a lot about the theory of time and such.
What did you read?
I read this book recently, the name escapes my mind right now, which talks of time as just another dimension. I wonder how you move around, left, right, forward, backward, up and down, and just add time as the fourth component. Really fascinating stuff.
Perhaps if making watches isn't your passion, you should focus more on your scientific interests?
You really think so? I've been musing over some theories and ideas in my spare time. Perhaps I should develop them a bit more.
No, that's it. That's all I want to know.
Oh, by the way, I saw that waiter man leave a key behind. I think it's to the staff storage. Do you know where he might be wandering around? Oh.
Hmm.
I was actually just about to speak with him. Just give it to me and I will pass it on. I'm taking control. Or do you want me to say I'm helping the staff?
Let's try one. See if it'll actually give us the key.
Oh, Grant, thank you for sparing me of having to talk to him.
Why don't you want to talk to him?
Oh, whoops.
No, it's fine, it's fine. So that's how we get the key.
Oh, fuck off, Jerry! Oh,
I still
here
don't see any animals.
Rose Hill High, this is Jerry's jacket.
Hmm.
Oh, okay, so that's how we find out about Jerry being the leader.
That's it?
I guess so.
Well.
Alright, now do you wanna... Let's go talk to Ophelia. You know what? Yeah, let's go talk to Ophelia. I was going to say, let's talk to Jerry. How do you do, Gov? I don't believe I've made your acquaintance. Let me introduce myself proper.
Go ahead.
My name is Ophelia Thatcher. Yes, those Thatchers.
I'm not familiar.
Why, you must not be from Galicia indeed. My father is one of the executives of Gal Media Incorporated, the first company to successfully bring voices right into people's homes, using the new and revolutionary radio technology. And my mother is the warm and gentle voice behind the broadcasts.
That sounds almost rehearsed.
You must imagine, being their daughter and the up-and-coming prodigy, it's hardly the first time I give this spiel. But let me backtrack a bit.
Oh, God.
Being born as a Thatcher has put much expectations on me, as you can imagine. I was lucky enough to be admitted to one of Antrim's top private schools, and spend what little time I have left attending many different causes.
I have some questions.
Yes?
What kind of schooling do you do?
Let's see. Just a typical worldly and science knowledge, mixed with basic etiquette and formal behavior.
Don't sound too excited about that.
Don't get me wrong, I'm not underestimating the lucky card I drew. But sometimes I feel we are too preoccupied with mere appearances rather than taking action. Okay. As I'm sure you are aware, there are turbulent times for Galicia. Especially with the 5-point plan just on the horizon, adding to the pressure.
Why are the times turbulent?
Besides the conflict, incessant violence, and hateful propaganda, well, this new plan is definitely heating things up. The 5-point plan will soon be unveiled by the new Prime Minister, trying to get the new ager and old agers talking again. If both sides approve it, it could finally lead to a peaceful revolution of the turmoil. I do believe I saw a newspaper clipping explaining it in more detail, if you are curious. Suffice to say, a lot hinges on its passing.
I think you might be too hopeful.
Perhaps, but either way, it creates a platform for open, peaceful discussion, and a lot of other things could be brought up on such a platform as well. With the influence of our radio and the Thatcher family's recognition, we could really push for the plan's acceptance, and force some more progressive ideas onto the agenda as well.
That's some clever thinking.
Exactly! We could reshape some of the plan's points for greater benefit of Galicia.
Benefit of Galicia according to you.
I don't believe Galicians would disagree about all those immigrants, but more importantly... Well... Have you noticed how all the executives and board members of Gal Media are male?
Yes.
Most people don't, which is exactly the problem. Our society would never allow a woman in such a high position. Yet we never stop to think why. My mother is just as ambitious and talented as my father, yet she will always have to hide it in his shadow.
But if she is just as ambitious and talented, why hasn't she tried to move up?
She attempted to attend a board meeting once. The puzzled men thought she came to deliver mail of some sort, and was asked to bring back the quarterly reports on the way back. You see, my mother is part of the old generation, the dinosaurs, those whose minds will not change. As sad as it is, there is little hope for her ever moving up in the ranks. But me, I still have the chance. I can shape the new wave. I can bring change, equality, or at least, that's what my mother's hope. Her mother hopes.
That's good spirit.
Yeah, yes, I suppose so.
Well?
I'm just not sure if that is wise to be more vocal. It is very dangerous to get involved like that.
Why is it dangerous?
Between the old and new ager, either side you pick, you will have enemies. Strong enemies. The kind of enemies that don't like powerful female speakers arguing against them. And I'm not even sure if Galicia is ready for such abrupt changes yet.
But if you don't speak out for those who cannot speak for themselves, who will?
Well, even risking potential backlash from the community, it's not something that can happen overnight. Progressive reform takes a lot of time, and you will need to wait for the proper moment.
How do you know when the time is right?
I guess that is a tricky question. With all the economic and cultural conflict going on, is it wise to risk further dividing the political scene with more radical social ideas?
Heated and violent debate over Galicia's future means important decisions are being made now. You should push your agenda and take advantage of that.
You give me something to think about. But I mustn't take you from other patrons with my grim subjects on such a hopeful evening. Please, do go mingle.
I'll come back later. Bye.
Okay, well, you learned quite a bit.
I want to kill the watchmaker.
What? Okay, fine. Okay, we killed the watchmaker. What the shit? Unexpected death shocks charity gala. Blah, blah, blah. Close to midnight, John Dow suddenly collapsed. Also announced his plans to harden some of his factory policies and increase work hours after some thought-provoking conversations he had that night. The disgruntled waiter, Franz Kohl, vocally quit in disgust. Mr. Selden also expressed reluctance to host future galas after a key to his private study room went missing. Oh, shit. So everything we do actually does affect this. On a brighter side, John Dower's death brought a lot of attention to the watches he donated, helping Rose Hill more than surpass its funding needs. The school will now be able to renovate their buildings, as well as expand new educational curriculums, and said the principal. Hopefully we can become a cornerstone and model for future reconciliation in Galicia. The violence on the rise, blah blah blah, Jerry O'Neill. Okay, so I'm starting to think that there might actually be a golden ending to that. To this.
Refuted.
Damn it. Well, we didn't help Ophelia. Well, still 3 years.
Oh, well.
The level of violence and random attacks increased. You made things more violent.
I still don't know how to end the animal violence. I don't know how to stop that.
An animal cruel... Well, obviously, we have to still talk shit. You're dead. Well, this is you. What happened?
You're dead. I'm sorry.
But why?
Somebody had to die tonight.
But why?
I simply did not like you.
Whoops. And I did then.
What did you push?
I accidentally pushed 3.
Oh. It wasn't personal.
I simply had to... But I'm still dead then. Well, yeah. Are you happy with yourself?
Hopefully next time I can do better.
What will happen to me now?
Heaven!
Oh, at least that is some consolation. What's heaven like?
Whatever you wish it to be.
Oh, well, that doesn't sound too bad. So I guess I step into the light or something?
Actually step into the next room and our secretary will take care of you.
How bureaucratic. I guess I'll ask them more questions. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Thank you, I guess.
One.
Bye. Why? What the fuck did he do to you?
Well, he was talking about time and dimensions and stuff. I was doing a thing.
Well, obviously, you did the thing. The thing was done. No. Fuck this. We're going on investigation now. Okay, we're going full-blown investigation mode. You are going to read the parts.
Okay.
Of the guests. Oh, well, no. You don't... No. Okay. You read our parts still. Well, we're going into full investigation mode.
Wait, I'm picking the number one still, or what?
You know what? Just sit back and relax and provide commentary. I guess. Okay, so, once again. Okay, so we're going to gather all the information we need to gather first. We might need to talk to Jerry.
Yeah. No, we talked to Jerry after we talked to the waiter because he has crepes for us.
Maybe. Oh, he does have crepes for us. True, okay. Okay, so first we're gonna go search, everywhere.
Wait, did we see the Margaret Thatcher? Or, yeah. The Thatcher's poster?
We did, yeah.
Okay.
And we saw that Franz Kohl was an asshole.
See, Dower's Crafts.
Okay, yeah. Okay. I mean, so far this game is charming at the very least.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, let's take it, and then let's... Okay, and then, yeah, we get this. Okay. So, who do you want to... Who do you think we should talk to first? Maybe get Bill Seldon's stuff out of the way?
Yeah, I guess.
And we're going to compliment him, actually.
Okay.
Tell me about yourself. Start at the beginning. I'm sorry to hear that. Very keen. Number two. Number one. Fascinating. As long as you're profits. Blah, blah, blah. Yes. Could create. Blah, blah, blah.
So now, whenever you ask anybody about, tell me about someone, he'll be able, he's one of the ones that you can ask about.
Yeah.
Which, right now, too, is going to be nobody.
There's nothing wrong with being single. Sounds like you may have some juicy stories to tell. I suppose you are right, close friends is all one really needs. Indeed, there is nothing finer in life than good wine, a cigar, and good friends. Tell me about yourself. Okay, let's... Okay. Okay, let's now talk to Franz. A glass of what? You know what? Whiskey. I wanted to ask you something. Tell me about Mr. Selden. By far one of the most respectable and fair employees I've had. That is all I can say. Can? Is there more you can't. But I am not one to discuss my employees behind their backs. Professional etiquette, you understand. Whom am I curious about? You know what? Let me ask something else. Tell me about the gala. Have you donated or brought anything? Ah, shit. I feel like I... Oh, that's right, he didn't...
His key came from, Dowser. Dower.
Well, it is Mr. Selden's house, so I just want the guests to respect his privacy. Nothing personal, you understand? Perhaps he shouldn't have opened his house to guests, then. Well, we do keep to try to keep... Well, we do try to keep the kitchen doors closed. Yeah, let's go get that key from, what's-his-face.
There he is.
Tell me about yourself. As skilled as your father. If you aren't as skilled as your father, blah, blah, blah. Have you considered other pursuits? That's all I wanted to know about you. I was actually about to speak with him. Why don't you want to talk to him? Oh, he's just so chat. Oh, well, shit. We're not the only one who got trapped into the dialogue tree. Oh, he's just so chatty.
Talking about Cole, though.
No. No, no, no. This one is, No, no, this one's Jerry, I believe. And when he gets on the topic of the workers' right... Oh, no, no, you're right. What about it? He complains so much about exploitation and the upper class putting him down. Can he just enjoy his craft for craft's sake?
Everybody needs to earn a living.
Like yourself? Yes, exactly. Let's talk about something else. You know what? I must be going. Okay. Who have we not killed?
Pretty much everybody except for Jerry and...
I mean, we did kill Jerry.
Yeah. We haven't killed any of the women yet.
That's true. You want to kill a woman?
Yeah, but I think there's a big movement if Thatcher stays alive. So your other choice is that one in black up there.
Yeah, that's Ekaterina.
Yeah.
That's the one I was going to suggest. But, however... Well, I did say we were going into full investigator mode.
That's true. We haven't talked to everyone yet.
That's true. Let's talk to Jerry about his stupid fucking bullshit.
What actually pops up under notebook then? I mean, I know some of the people are showing up, but...
A lot, apparently. Oh, wow, there's, like, bullet points and stuff, too. Yeah, okay. Unmarried with no children, used to be a self-admitted ladies' man in the past. After speaking with you, he was intrigued by your pro-New-Ager beliefs. Okay, let's talk to Jerry. You do this one.
Okay, hello.
Hey, my name is Jerry, lol. I'm a student at Rose Hill High, volunteering at the event tonight.
Oh, what are you doing?
Just small stuff. I carry food, I get people's coats, nothing major.
What is this event for?
You must have heard about the incident, right? A school got vandalized all bad. Some folks weren't happy that it allows both New Ager and Old Ager students.
What are Old Agers and New Agers?
Well, you see, I'll be from Galicia. Old Ages and New Ages are the names of the two sides of the Galician turmoil. The first wants to preserve our culture and tradition, mainly composed of small local businesses and owners and various labor workers. The New Agers are mostly the wealthy businessmen or big public speakers who are pushing for industrial progress and more open economy and immigration laws.
Ah, I see. Anyway.
Yeah?
What is your favorite subject?
Well, I do like our history class, especially the archaeology bit, and I took an elective in business marketing. That was really fun, too.
What do you study at your school?
Math, literature, history, all sorts of things, all sorts of things.
Didn't I just ask that? Why did you decide to volunteer tonight?
Well, I think it's good to get out and meet new successful people at an event like this.
So you're here mainly for networking?
Oh, of course not. I'm here to help out my school too. But it doesn't hurt if I benefit from it, right?
No, but it hints you have some ulterior motives.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to come off that way. I just meant it's good for both my school and me. And I get to meet Mr. Selton in person. Really, Mr. Selton is an inspirational businessman.
How is he inspirational?
I mean, he took his father's so-so business and completely turned it around, finding new markets and opportunities.
Don't many business owners do that, though?
Yes, but not so many do it as efficiently and quickly as Mr. Selton did. Originally, his father produced only small home products, glasses, jars, that kind of stuff. But when Mr. Selton took over, he expanded to windowing, with a whole new method of cheaply making glass sheets. It was a brilliant move on his part. I mean, he really is like a textbook example of a successful businessman.
Sounds like you really want to be like him when you grow up.
Oh, in many ways, yes. Although I wouldn't want to just pursue business for the money.
What kind of ways?
Oh, just how smart and pragmatic he is. Or even tonight's gala. I hope Mr. Selton does not abandon his Galician roots.
I'm not sure I follow.
There are so many beautiful things that define what being a Galician is. Our language, music, food, even something like when we tap 3 times on the mirror when entering a house as a guest. No other country actually does that. I thought that was so cool when I learned it in anthropology class. And I will be right back because I have to use the restroom.
Back! And almost choked
myself.
Be
sure to tap on the mirror. Cord.
He's not paying attention.
Are you kidding me? Oh, I thought he was.
I didn't even have my headphones on. Okay.
It's not that cool.
Oh. I don't know. I think if you want to... Okay, so here's the thing about investigation, right?
Okay. That's important for your cultural identity.
In investigation, if you want to learn information, you gotta oftentimes... Do you not know how to perform espionage?
No.
What the shit is wrong with you?
By the way, he picked one.
Okay, well, one. That's important for your cultural identity. I mean, I just really think it's important that we don't let money or success make us forget these things, you know? Too often, the New Agers pursue progress for progress's sake, completely abandoning our culture.
But what if the new is better than the old?
Of course, there's many inventions that are useful, like the automobiles, but progress should add to our legacy, not take away from it, like with the Baker's Revolt.
What was the Baker's Revolt, even though we know?
Apparently, a New Asia baker was trying to save money by taking raisins out from our traditional holiday bread. Aww. Big argument followed that led to him getting shot. But it's just a horrible example of how profits make us forget our tradition.
Yeah, I'm gonna read it. If you define your culture by raisins, I think you already have bigger problems than that.
In the end, as the big industrialists grow their businesses, the small folk who cherish our culture just get left behind.
How did they get left behind?
Small family shops can't compete with big New Agers. Many have been closing down. What if they all closed and only one big store was left? They could do whatever they want, make prices high, or pay their workers very little. They would have so much control. This is not
Walmart.
A met. What?
Walmart.
You sounded like you were having a bit of a sneezing problem, even with you trying to perform espionage.
And... I said Walmart.
Yeah, I was about to say, this is a metaphor.
Mm-hmm.
Totally not a metaphor, but yeah.
Eh.
Anyway, and the division between social classes widens. Yes, exactly, and that can lead to the rich overpowering the poorer folk. Look at Trenter. When the old-age locals renovated old buildings and opened beautiful gardens, it attracted rich industrialists and their hipsterian children, who slowly pushed them out, benefiting from their work. That's not evolving our culture, that's taking it over. And the government did nothing, lobbied by New Age People of Peace Party to keep quiet. Public never realized, swayed by the mass propaganda. The old age of voice got completely marginalized. That's not what democracy should be. No surprise, riots followed.
That's terrible.
Yes, exactly. That's why the TFF came about, to give old ages their voice back. Now, here's the thing. Another tip with espionage. Ignorance is a big thing, okay? Willful ignorance is a big thing. So, even if you... Yes, even if you do know something, sometimes someone might... You might get information if some... Like, this is video game logic, of course, but if you play ignorant, you might get new pieces of information than if you were to just skip it.
Okay. What's TFF?
Wow, you're not really not from here, are you? No, not really. Oh, one of my classmates is an immigrant, too. But anyway... The Trenter Freedom Force is the biggest group that organizes many protests and events to bring attention to the old age cause. They're the only ones fighting for the small folk.
Are they a terrorist or organization?
No,
I know we don't want to play that one.
How did the group come about? I learned about that in history class too. There was a protest in Trenton a while back, and the government sent in soldiers to contain it. Many innocent people got hurt. Some even died. The TFF was founded as a result of that. But now because of the more New Age pressure, the government calls them terrorists, because apparently they are responsible for some of the violent acts, too.
I want to say four.
You seem to align with their views. Hey, Isaac! 3020 is in here.
Oh, I was wondering. I was like, it said my friend Cecilia Lover 897. I'm like, or 987. I'm like, who?
Yeah, there was some confusion. Mega sent me a message about this. His name got confused with another Twitch user, and so it was a thing.
Okay.
But anyway, you seem to align with their views. I mean, sometimes if you care about your rights and love your country, but the government doesn't listen, sometimes you just need to stand up and make them listen, right?
You might have a point.
I agree. Equal representation is the foundation of democracy and must be protected by all means. So you agree that some things like the bombing scares are understandable to bring attention to our cause if there's no other way to be heard? You know what? If everything else failed, then yes. Desperate times sometimes call for desperate actions, Jerry! I'm glad you understand. Thank you for reaffirming my thoughts. It's a hard choice sometimes, but someone has to make it. In any case, I should probably check on the other guests, see if they need anything. Haha, Isaac is good. Okay. So, you just want to kill the woman and be it done with? Oh, I know, that's right. Damn it, we're in investigator mode. Damn it.
You keep trying.
I'm not this patient right now.
I still want to know more about that lady in the thing. Wait, is there a mirror we can tap on?
Oh, that is a good thing. We should probably look for that now.
Although this whole house, and I don't think we ran into a bathroom or anything.
Oh, there's a portrait. Does that count?
Nope.
Ah, damn it. Well,
I don't think that was a bathroom. That was a kitchen.
Yeah, I mean, there's no mirror in here either.
You talk about a mirror, then it's like...
Why is there an oven in here?
That's the only way they could heat the house?
But there's an oven in here, too!
Actually, there's two in there. There's one on the other.
Yeah, what the... I mean, this is a kitchen. I understand this. This is a fucking broom closet. Okay, what? Are employees, like, sneaking away into here?
I don't know.
Okay, so if employees are sneaking away in here to make lunch, I think Mr. Selden has a problem with his eyesight, because there's a gigantic fucking stove in his broom closet. Okay, so what else do you... Okay. I gotta channel, I think, Ulysses' mindset would be the best to channel here. You are the only one, Isaac.
Aw. Oh, well,
I'm kidding.
Yeah, that's kind of true.
Okay. Shit. I need to channel my investigator PC.
Does the notebook say anything about the picture?
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, so let's check the notebook. Where the fuck is my mouse? Okay. The picture?
Doesn't still don't see anything on there.
Yeah. Jerry. We might have fucked up with Jerry. Okay.
I am a little confused about him, too, though. Because he started off talking like New Ager, and then it was like Old Ager, and then it's like, well, which one are you?
Well, he's obviously about unity. I think we need a bigger picture. Now that we talked to Jerry, let's talk to Franz about Jerry. No, tell me about Jerry.
Oh, we could give his key back.
What? No.
It said, I have your key.
Oh. A very lively kid, and one who will bring you any snack you may desire tonight. Talk to him if you are getting hungry. Oh, well. You know what? Let me ask something else. I believe I have a key you might have left behind. Oh, thank you. Mr. Selden would not have been happy to lose that. Oh, you're welcome. How may I be of service? Okay.
Well, that was kind of meh.
Which key did we...
We already opened the door, so it shouldn't matter.
Tell me about Jerry. He's a kid, you know what they say. So promising! Our next generation! The future is in their hands, and all the other pseudo-inspirational muck. But I don't care for kids, so don't ask me.
You don't have any kids of your own?
Thank God, no, and I never will. What else do you want from me?
Let's talk about a different topic altogether.
Maybe about the conflict? Frankly, it's not my cup of tea. I would rather not get involved.
How can you say that? It's your country.
It is your country! No, it's not. I'm not from Galicia. Oh, hold on. Let's speak to Ophelia. Okay. Or maybe that's the wrong order. We got 20 more minutes of this, and then we're killing the lady in black. But still, we got 20 more minutes of this, okay? We got to investigate.
Let's talk about a certain topic.
Let's talk to Ophelia.
We're already dead. We can't really do much anyways.
I have some questions. How do you feel about the Old Ager cause? Understand the plight of the common folk.
Oh, that's right. This round, we haven't talked to her about her standing up and...
Oh, that's right. If we replace traditional Galician goods with those generics made by cheap foreign labor, or keep letting more immigrants in, we will lose those things entirely. Eventually, our country will become just like all the others.
1897, you say?
Uh-huh. Yeah, good old 1897. I mean, yes, yes, it's certainly not, you know... Oh, what is it, 120 years later? And we're still talking about this same old bullshit? You know, how is that bad? Aren't we all humans? Well, yes, but we're not all the same. We should be proud of our history and our country. Cultural differences should be celebrated, not erased. But of course it's hard, with the government increasingly allowing more foreigners in. Why would your government do that?
Cheap labor, foreign investors, investments. In the end, somebody profits, while Galicia is stuck with a new social class to support. So many immigrants just don't understand us or our traditions. Can you believe one of the patrons who wasn't born in Galicia didn't even tap the mirror? Shameful.
Where is this mirror?
Oh! No! No, this is good. We may not have had the dialogue option. Or we may not have known that, yes, three times when you are a guest. And so we would have had to guess at random, but we got that information from Jerry. So, yes, three times.
Okay.
Yes, exactly. That's how I know I'm speaking with a true Galician.
Sure.
Well, I just believe it is rude to come to someone's house and not respect their own rules. Those kinds of people aren't ready for Galicia's gift.
Perhaps they... You know what? Wise words, Miss Thatcher.
Well, isn't it on them to educate themselves if they choose to come and live here?
You know what? How? Maybe you should help them.
If they can ever learn. Hopefully it is something that can be discussed at the new 5-point plan. If not, we will still have our voice on the Thatcher's radio.
Oh, fuck you.
Why haven't I seen you snooping into Mr. Selden's study room a bit earlier?
That was somebody else.
It must have been somebody else. You know what? No. Mr. Selden let me in.
Well, that's surprising. He must have great trust in you, then. It's his beautiful house he welcomed us into.
Why is everyone bashing us?
Because we appear foreign. I don't like either of those choices.
Perhaps he shouldn't have opened his house to guests, then.
Well, the house is open, but I thought those doors were locked. In any case...
You know what? Let's ask her... Did we ask her about Jerry?
No, but let's ask her number 5.
Ah, okay.
You know, she's an immigrant.
Oh, one of the two lovely ladies still left at the gala.
Oh, so she is lovely then.
Of course, and isn't it great to see more independent women coming to events such as these? But frankly, I haven't learned much chatting with her as much as I tried. She does keep to herself a bit.
Why do you think that is?
Not everyone isn't outspoken or chatty as us, I suppose. All's fair, of course.
If you come to a social event, you need to be ready to mingle, dammit!
Perhaps, but as far as I know, she currently lives in the small town of Hangfors, so I'm not surprised she may not be used to such big, fancy crowds. In any case, let us respect her privacy and speak of something else.
Now, wait a minute. Hangfors.
Kill the bitch! Kill the bitch!
20 minutes!
Kill the bitch!
Okay.
We're stopping the animal violence here! We killed the bitch!
Wow, there's not a lot to her article.
A fundraising gala for the benefit of the recently vandalized Rose Hill High School, closing to midnight, Ekaterina, no last name, suddenly collapsed. The cause of death is still unknown, explained Dr. Vimes, but initial analysis suggests heart failure. Okay, CEO increased work hours. TFF turns to radical. Oh, okay, this is new. This is new.
Yeah.
Trenter Freedom Force, the most radical and violent pro-old-ager terrorist group in the country, took a strange turn in leadership today, proclaiming young Jerry O'Neill, blah blah blah. Jerry's rather fanatical involvement with the organization was uncovered shortly after charity gala for the benefit of a school hosted by the successful businessman. Someone once told me, desperate times call for desperate actions.
Us?
Yeah, kind of us.
What?
It reassured me that the average folk of Galicia do understand the TFF plea, and that our means are justified. We might have wanted to disguise ourselves as immigrants, now that I think about it. The group, condemning the recently hardened pro-New-Ager work policies and viewpoints expressed by businessmen such as aforementioned Mr. Selden, combined with Jerry's more aggressive stance, has been intensifying their violent activity and employing even more deadly tactics than ever before.
There's more violence.
It's still refuted and shit. Okay, so 3 years again.
No longer terrorized by animals.
Yeah, we save the animals! Hankfurs, we save the animals! That was the goal, that's it.
More violence, but we save the animals!
Huh? What happened? You are dead and I'm sorry. But why? I am the Reaper and I chose you. But why did you choose me? Well, you seem the most dangerous. What? How come? Based on the information I found. I guess I don't have the best rapport then. Yeah, let that be a lesson to you. You're already dead. It doesn't matter. Are you happy with yourself choosing me to die? You know what? It's the best choice I could have made given what I knew. So what'll happen to me now? Oh yeah, you're going to hell. Well, that's rather harsh. What's hell like? Everything you wanted in life, but opposite. I suppose you can't blame me if I'm not too excited about that. So I guess it's into the light or something? Yeah, bye. Just go. Bye.
That's it. I don't know why I gave you option after that.
That's it. We did it. We went investigator mode and we uncovered our true goal, which was stopping the animal violence. Thank you for joining us for Postmortem One Must Die. Thank you to whoever watches this video, and let it be known that we saved the animals. And that is what matters in life. Good night, and good luck. Stay classy, and all that other jargon.